motivated.
Get motivated.
Get motivated. Hip hop motivated. Blowing wisdom on the mic with Sean.
All right, I hope you all are motivated. Welcome to Hour 2 of Flow of Wisdom Radio. I am your host, Sean Anthony, and we are live on the Genesis Communications Network. We do the show live every Sunday, 3 to 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. The subject, this is the third part of the series, CERN Portals and Ley Lines. And, of course, at the first, the opening of the show, I shared some information that I've been privy to about some significant training that has been going on, and also the heightened security measures being taken at this Republican convention that's going to take place in Cleveland, Ohio, here in July. And looking at the security measures taken, we're talking about every type of agency from the FBI to the CIA to Homeland, Department of Homeland Security, FEMA, all the way down to state troopers and so on and so forth are doing their due diligence in providing the necessary security measures revolving around this Republican convention that's set to take place in Cleveland in July. Also, this training that's going on, it's not just your normal type of training. This is radiological nuclear training that's going on. And some of the information that I shared in the first hour, this training, of course, obviously isn't open for everyone. You have to have the right credentials. You have to have the right security numbers, the security ID, and it comes from FEMA. And one of the things that I just thought was really interesting, what was shared with me, was the fact that the person said that one of the instructors said, "Have you ever heard of Area 51?" And everyone was like, "Yeah, yeah." Well, we're from the other 50. And I swear, when I heard that, my mouth just dropped. It's like, okay, well, it kind of makes sense now that you think about it. You know, if it's called Area 51, then where is Areas 1 through 50 at? So with that being said, these people that are doing this training, in addition, in cahoots with FEMA, as well as some other organizations there, they're getting our first responders prepared. And again, I don't think there's anything wrong with our government or first responders getting the necessary training for a possible threat. Well, my question is what do they know? What do they know? I was told that training is when they know something is about to happen or they are about to do something. So we'll keep that open. Coming up here shortly, we're going to talk about portals and ley lines, vortexes, some interesting information I want to share with you guys on spirit portals and energy vortexes. All of this stuff is all tied in, and we're going to link it in the CERN. But right now, let's go back to the phones, 877-300-7645. Don in Ohio, didn't mean to cut you so short, Don, at the last segment, but we have plenty of time now, man. You said you're in Ohio. You worked at a nuclear power plant?
Yes, I did. And I did have some of that training. The only difference is I wouldn't have been responding. I would have been evacuated.
Right.
And that's why I recognized what you were saying with that. And it seems to me, even though there is emphasis on if there was a nuclear exchange, of course, you know, these areas that they're in, they'd be tucked away safe and everything because they'd have to stay on the ground for a number of days before they would come out to see if there was anybody alive or how they could help them. And the other emphasis I see on that is the fact is dirty bombs. Suitcase bombs, because a suitcase bomb, which we know that that threat has been on America, what they call the perfect day, where they're planning on exploding nuclear weapons across the country in key cities. And of course, what would happen is initially 100,000 people would die with a suitcase bomb. From the nuclear radiation, another 100,000 to 200,000 would die from the contamination. They would get sick days after and die. And if the person had the unfortunateness to be looking in the way of the flash, at the flash when it went off, that person would be totally blind.
Wow.
That's how deadly this stuff is. And our nation knows that. We have this threat, which is why I don't understand why we don't slam that border. But the other thing, the other threat would be if would be sabotage against a nuclear power plant. Because if there was sabotage against a nuclear power plant, it could affect at a minimum a 50-mile radius. So anyone living within that 50-mile radius would be affected for radiation. That I know is a fact because, like I said, I understand the evacuation sequence and everything.
You know, something also that I found on the FEMA website, it was talking about this REP, Disaster Initiated Review course, saying the purpose of a DIR is to determine the capability of off-site emergency response infrastructure following an extended plant shutdown or shutdown caused by electric grid blackouts, malevolent act, there we go, pandemic or natural disaster such as a hurricane, tornado, flood, storm, earthquake in the vicinity of commercial nuclear power plants. This course is designed to provide the student with fundamental knowledge of the disaster initiated review, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Another thing, you know, it talked about electric grid blackouts or an EMP attack. You know, our infrastructures, from my understanding, when doing a show on EMP attacks, we're not that secure as we should be, especially against an EMP attack. And one of the things that you know could be attack that's vulnerable, like you mentioned, are the power plants. Any type of interference with that, even if it's a cybersecurity hack, it could be pretty significant.
That's exactly true. Things could go into a meltdown.
Don, you said something that also brought up some interest to me. You said the perfect day bomb, and you said where there would be a series of nuclear bombs that would go off simultaneously across the country or across the globe.
Well, across the country, because years ago, Homeland Security ran across plans, and this would be from those that you know, like the terrorist groups organizations. What they have done is they've mapped out key cities like Los Angeles, Seattle, Chicago, Houston, Atlanta, Detroit, New York, or whatever, and to set these bombs off all at one time in one day to throw this country into total chaos. And our nation knows this. And that's why I said it bewilders me that we don't understand why we need a secure border, because everybody coming across that border is not some innocent person that's trying to seek a better life. We got wolves coming in sheep clothing, because many of the people that they found coming across the border, they emanate from the Middle East. And they're coming here to group up with cell groups. They've even found Mexican nationals that have helped these people. And there's people, they just ignore this. I mean, they know that ISIS over there is using the cartel, is helping them to infiltrate into our nation. Our nation knows that. But, of course, this is never told in the main media. This is only told by people who are dedicated and informing the people, like yourself, alternative media. People will never know this. This is happening every day. There's a website people can go to. It's called Border Sheriffs. And these sheriffs have been along the border in Arizona, along the Mexican border, for years. And they tell about the fact is that people come across the border every night through people's ranches, shoot these ranches up. And the fact is, when they look in the morning, what did they find? They found dead bodies. They found prayer rugs. They found Qurans. This has been going on for 8 years or more. And yet and still, we don't want to build, we don't want to secure our border. Yes, we need a wall. We need to militarize our border. They got to have tunnels dug up under the ground, the cartel. But see, what people don't realize about the cartel could be mobilized into an army to destroy us. They don't love us. There are 800 to a million cartel members in Mexico. And these people, some of them are working with terrorist organizations. They have no love for this country. Man. But yet and still, let's keep the door open. You know, I mean, you know, I help homeless people all the time. I've taken them to shelters. But let me tell you something. I would not bring a bunch of homeless people home to my house and say, you know, just lay around, do what you want to do, and me and my family, we're going to go in the room and sleep. That would be stupid. Well, where I control access into my house is my door.
Right.
I control who comes in, and I control who goes out. That's wisdom. And that's the same thing we need to do at our border. And any politician that won't address that is a total idiot.
Right.
Thus say the Lord.
There you go. Don has spoken. Don, thanks for the call, man. That's good. Good insight, man. I appreciate the call.
All right. God bless you.
You too. Don in Ohio. He's all for securing the borders. And who's going to pay for it? It's like, nah, as Donald Trump would say. You know, it's something interesting that Don just said about this perfect day scenario. How these terrorists have all, you know, plotted of igniting several bombs in several major cities in the country simultaneously. It reminds me of a TV show on Netflix called Jericho, and it's exactly what Don just said. It shows what happens when the bomb goes off and the aftermath. Exactly what Don says, you know, and you know, for years they always say, you know, they got to let you know before they do it. You know, they put it in movie and entertainment and in the news and information. How crazy is that? If anyone ever seen that show, Jericho, it's only like two seasons, one season. It's on Netflix. And it has not been produced anymore. We'll be right back, y'all. It's Flow of Wisdom. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are back live here at Flow of Wisdom Radio. I am Sean Anthony, your host. My website is flowofwisdom.com. We're live every Sunday, 3 to 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Toll-free number is 1-877-300-7645. Interesting article on supernaturalmagazine.com. And let me put a disclaimer that, you know, I'm just merely sharing this for information. Okay? I'm not saying that I buy into it or I subject to this or I believe, you know, in this whole thingy thing, you know, the people, the person that wrote this, you know, because they're into all of that esoteric type stuff. But nonetheless, I'm sharing this for mere information, because I believe that you can pull meat from fat from just about anywhere. But anyway, this article is called Spirit Portals and Energy Vortexes. Have you ever noticed when you walked into an area of unusual temperature change where it's a more vivid color than the surrounding area? There's a blurring, perhaps, or a sense of enhanced energy. Well, you may have stumbled across an energy vortex which houses a spirit or interdimensional portal. Some physicists believe that, on average, most homes contain at least one of these portals. Ladies and gentlemen, have you ever experienced anything like this before? Do you believe that most homes have some sort of portal? I would love to hear your story. Continuing on, in technical terms, a spirit portal is a region of space that has a four-dimensional vibratory frequency, where this region of three-dimensional physical plane and the four-dimensional etheric plane merge into each other through the aid of an energy vortex. In simple terms, a spirit portal is a doorway in the physical world that allows free access to and from the spirit world. The existence of a portal can rely on a vortex of energy to sustain it. This is an area of mass energy and a high concentration. usually originating from magnetic, spiritual, or sometimes unknown sources that create powerful eddies that manifest a spiral of energy which can be positive or negative in nature. It's interesting listening to the author of this article explain what a portal is, a spirit portal and energy vortexes, because, and this is the reason why I'm sharing this article, because comparing that, this information, I'm going to continue on because he has some more interesting stuff he shares. Comparing that to the information that I've provided from these scientists on CERN, the Large Hadron Collider, it almost goes hand in hand, explaining it more from this esoteric perspective compared to a scientific perspective. Does that make sense, guys? I hope I'm making sense. But I just find that very interesting. Vortexes tend to exist when there are strong concentration, listen at this, of gravitational anomalies. This in turn creates an area that can bend light and cause considerable distortion in the human energy field. They have also been shown to be associated with ley lines and have been found to be considerably stronger at node points where several ley lines cross. I remember when I had Cisco Wheeler on the show, and she broke down ley lines like I haven't heard before. Ley lines. From my understanding, the city of Washington, D.C. is built and established in such a way that it's on ley lines. Energies. Certain energies are at play. Certain locations. I mean, look, I don't know about you, but have you ever gone to some place, whether it was someone's home or some kind of, you know, establishment, and you walk in and you just, the energy is just off. You like, I'm not feeling this place. Something's not right here. I'm going to leave out as soon as possible. I've experienced that numerous times. I don't know if you have or not, but we're going to continue on. Spirit portals and energy vortex. Welcome back. Flow of Wisdom Radio. I am Sean Anthony. Toll-free number is 1-877-300-7645. The website is flowofwisdom.com. It will connect you to all of my social media outlets. Continuing on with this article here, Supernatural Magazine. Vortexes and portals can be categorized according to direction and nature of energy flow. Two examples are upflow vortexes, positive portals. This is where the energy is flowing upward out of the earth. These vortexes are generally revitalizing and feel positive. The energy here feels more electric than magnetic and is said to boost spiritual skills to stretch and expand the consciousness. This energy is male or yang in nature, thus exhilarating and lively. I'm sure you guys heard of the phrase yin and yang. Inflow vortexes or negative portals. This is where the energy is flowing inward toward the earth. The energy here feels heavier and more negative if unprepared for its downward impact. Fear is often experienced at these sites if you are not ready. The ensuing introspection. These vortexes are linked with female or yin energy, and are best for healing and self-realization. These portals are more famous but less common. If you encounter a negative portal, you will feel like you're in the middle of a hurricane or a hurricane of negative energy and emotions. You'll feel anger, hate, fear, jealousy, and depression. Highly sensitive people will become victims of nightmares and feelings of oppression as the negative entities make use of the portal. I don't know about you, but this stuff is interesting. because we're talking about, like, we talk about it all the time in referencing the scripture, spiritual warfare, principalities, etc. Listen at this here. The article continues on with mirrors and water are also popular ways of creating a portal to the other side. They are effective as long as the user knows how to use them properly, control them, and ultimately close them down properly afterwards. Otherwise, you leave yourself open to unwanted guests using the portal. Many people inadvertently open portals and don't even know they've done anything until the knock-on effects become apparent. It is far more technical to close a portal than it is to open one. Let me take a quick little sidetrack here. I remember someone telling me that this particular person strategically puts mirrors in their house in certain places and will not put mirrors like at the front of the door. Like when you walk into this person's home, if there is a mirror right there at the front door, that they call it bad luck. It brings off bad luck. It brings off, you know, bad spirits, whatever may present itself at the door. And reading this information, I kind of see where they come from now, you know. It's really interesting. Anyway, it goes on. There are both positive and negative portals. But why do our spirit guides, and this is where I don't, you know, go into the whole spirit guides thing, and other ascended beings allow the negative portals to exist? The answer lies in two words: free will. All humans possess free will, the free will to make choices and design our own destiny. Both positive and negative portals can be created by free will. They both exist because they have been called into existence. If our spirit guides stop the opening of negative portals, this would mean that we as humans are not true masters of our destinies, and we have no free will. One type of energy would then have ultimate hold. So with light, we must have dark to keep the balance between our dimension and that of other dimensions. Portals and vortexes exist more abundantly than we are aware of. We rarely see them with the naked eye, but we can measure their effects with scientific and divination tools, such as digital thermometers or pendulums. We can also feel or sense their effects by the energy vibrations, direction of flow, and the subsequent entities that use them. Portals are not always required for other dimensions to interact with ours, but they serve as a more convenient way of bridging the interdimensional divide and enabling interaction and experience between the different planes of existence. Tell me that isn't food for thought. Something interesting in the Smithsonian it was a brief little interview with the Harvard University physicist or theorist Lisa Randall. And she's got this new book called Knocking on Heaven's Door. She's all into the Large Hadron Collider. But in her book, she talks about how physics may transform our understanding of the fundamental nature of the world. She thinks an extra dimension may exist close to our familiar reality. It's hidden except for a bizarre sapping of the strength of gravity as we see it. She also ponders the makeup of dark matter, unseen particles that have shaped the growth of the entire cosmos. These ideas, once the sole province of fiction writers, face real tests in a new generation of experiments. Sensitive detectors now sniff for dark matter. While the most complex scientific machine ever created, the Large Hadron Collider, beneath the border of Switzerland and France, smashes subatomic particles into one another at almost the speed of light. All of these stories, these are totally different articles from, you know, different spectrums, but they all talking about the same thing. It's crazy. 877-300-7645. The totally unthinkable. In 2016, CERN's Large Hadron Collider could unveil unknown dimensions of the universe. This is according to the Daily Galaxy. Going beyond the standard model would mean that there is yet another unbelievable idea out there, something that is totally unthinkable, said CERN senior physicist Paris Sfikas. In 2016, the Large Hadron Collider could unveil whole new dimensions, help explain dark matter and dark energy, of which we have no understanding, but which together make up 95% of the universe. This is amazing. Scientists have been gearing up for these experiments with the Large Hadron Collider. And of course, plans got thwarted by a weasel. 877-300-7645. Leroy is shouting out the weasel that threw the monkey wrench in CERN's plans. Leroy from Atlanta, welcome back to Floor of Wisdom, man. How are you?
Hey, you mean the essay, God works in mysterious ways, don't he?
Well, I like the way Don said it, man. He used a weasel. When man tries to interfere with things, God has a small way of saying, hold up.
Oh, most definitely.
Yep.
But to comment on your topic, have you ever given thought to the relation that, well, I'll just put it like this. All those who are interested in CERN and want to make it happen, just get on the boat and go to the Bermuda Triangle. Problem solved. You can go there or the Mandarin Trench on the other side of the world and, you know, just see if you can come out of there. Because those are portals that have been known for a while. But as far as eerie feeling you get when you're in certain places, mm-hmm. and I didn't really think of, I thought about the border towns because I've been to Albuquerque, New Mexico, and if you go to Memphis, Tennessee, and Chattanooga, Tennessee, just a weird feeling I get when I'm there because it's always a border town, and CERN is sitting on the border of France and Switzerland.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not a mistake. It's definitely something that's intentional. But as far as going to the Word with it, I think it was John who spoke to praying for an angel to come, and the prince of Persia, which was a spirit, was holding an angel back from coming to him.
Hmm.
So all of this that scientists don't believe in God, I mean, the fact that they use divination,
mm-hmm.
can
mm-hmm.
they be more satanic?
Yeah, right. Yeah. And, you know, going back to the show, I did part two where I was talking about Mount Graham in Arizona and how the Apache Indians have been trying to block the Vatican and Arizona University and the government from getting there what they considered sacred land. That's also considered a portal. And I just find it so interesting how the Vatican, along with Arizona University, strong-armed their way to that Mount Graham and built their laboratories there and their Lucifer telescope in that region. I just find it interesting because there has to be some sort of energy for them to strong arm the natives to America in their particular land that they considered sacred. They just strong armed them. So there have had to have been some kind of, had to have been. There is some sort of energy going on there in Mount Graham as well as other places.
I also find it weird, though, that they are ready to attribute creation, all of it, 95%, to dark matter instead of the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
They say, oh, yeah, Satan made all this. They won't say Satan, but if you're flirting with dark matter, that's
yeah. All right, Leroy, thanks for the call. We got to take a break here. When we come back, guys, don't go anywhere. I'm going to wrap up the show with some interesting information here. Boy, this is really crazy. The Large Hadron Collider. Oh, man. Portals and ley lines. It's all intertwined. We'll be back with more on Flow of Wisdom Radio. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, Flow of Wisdom Radio. I am your host, Sean Anthony. Website is flowofwisdom.com. We do the show every Sunday, 3 to 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on the Genesis Communications Network. Please help spread the word about Flow of Wisdom Radio. Share the links and just talk about it. Talk about the subjects that I bring up with others, you know, and see what kind of conversations you, how the conversations may go. Going back to this article, and I was sharing about the Big Bang Theory could be debunked by the Large Hadron Collider, written by Sarah Napton. She's the science editor, and this came out last year. But some interesting things that I wanted to point out in this article that I didn't get a chance to get to yet. The fact that it says, quote, "We have calculated the energy at which we expect to detect these mini black holes in gravity's window," and which is a new theory. If we do detect many black holes at this energy, then we will know that both gravity's rainbow and extra dimensions are correct, says Dr. Mira Faisal, told phys.org. When this Hadron Collider is fired up, it will smash protons together at nearly double the energy that was used to find the Higgs boson. Ralph Heuer, who is the director general of CERN, said the switch on would create, quote, "a new era for physics, which could also shed light on dark matter, dark energy, and supersymmetry," saying, "I want to see the first light in the dark universe. If that happens, then nature is kind to me." Scientists believe that they could find the first proof of alternative realities that exist outside our own universe. We predict that gravity, this is interesting here, we predict that gravity can leak into extra dimensions. And if it does, then miniature black holes can be produced at the Large Hadron Collider. Normally, when people think of the multiverse, they think of the many worlds interpretation of quantum mechanics, where every possibility is actualized. Every possibility is actualized. This cannot be tested, and so it is philosophy and not science. This is not what we mean by parallel universes. What we mean is real universes in extra dimensions, as gravity can flow out of our universe into the extra dimensions. What do you think is going to come out of this when you're tapping into this type of stuff, and they're talking about gravity going into other universes and other dimensions? Well, what happens if there's gravity on the other end? What's going to come out of this? They've been upgrading this Large Hadron Collider. The particle counter boasts new magnets, superior psychrogenics, higher voltage, and higher beams. They've cranked this thing up to the highest that they possibly can at this point. And I tell you, something is going on. Last week, I put this on my social media, and it was just a mere spiritual observation. I just sensed that something was going on in the atmosphere. The series of things that was happening in sequence as my morning was going that day, I just got that sense, that feeling. Something's going on in the unseen world. And when I posted that on my social media, man, not so much the response on my social media, but the phone calls I received personally, and some of the stories and information that some people have shared with me from all over the different parts of the world and in the country, people reaching out to me. It's just amazing. But nonetheless, look, we're going to keep on keeping on, guys. Look, make sure you rock out with me next Sunday. We'll be live, Lord willing, 3 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Live life, get wisdom, and let it flow. Peace.